slippy this morning. Sweet Lamb Baja Rally Championship. It's pretty cold today. I'm gonna take a little bit to get into a groove. Coming up to row three. Try and get past some back markers safely. What are you doing? Oh mate. Oh. I should have stopped and helped really, but I'm sorry Quinny, I'd like to think you'd tell me off if I stopped and lost time helping. How has he ended up in there? First lap, I've got 3.5 hours straight through to do this, so I'm not in a hurry. Plan is just to tick laps down. I know I'm the first in my class, so as long as I don't see anyone else in my class and I can get a fast lap in at some point, then we'll be grand. Nice berm here. Use the berm. Right, tight left here, cut the corner. And then down the hill. Been a bit cautious because it's quite cold and slick. All right, coming up to the pit area now. This is a coming up ahead is where our lap time will actually start counting. That's where the timing strip on the floor is. Just taking my time. No need to rush. And then blue tape is walker pace area. One thing that Sweet Lamb do really well is they have marshals in all of the walking pace areas, and they marshal it really well actually. If you are going fast through the pits, then Matey Boy down there will hold you up and give you a bollocking. So well done Sweet Lamb, that's something that most enduro organisers don't tend to. Hey, there you go. You tell him! See, told you. Right. Let's get Mr. Pluto. And into the woods. Nice little woodland section through here. Doesn't last long. Lots of mud on the outside here. Lots of grip. Oh fucking hell! There. This half pack is just really, really slick. Feel the front trying to tuck. I actually broke my hand here last year doing just that, so I'll try and avoid that. looks like you've got more grip than you do, because this this hardback stuff is really slick. Seems a lot slicker this morning than it was yesterday afternoon. Section up here, and I will probably stick that in, because yesterday we went all the way up there, so I'll probably show that now instead of this. think, oh, there they are. There's the two bikes. So the race has been restarted. I'm apparently second place in class. I'm just following this 1290 ahead of me. Both in the 1000cc twins. Compared to how it was yesterday, it's certainly more of a challenge. Like this that are wet, rutted, and they're really hard to predict where the grip is. Where possible, I'm trying to stay out of a 1290 roost. 1290 roost is not something that you want to get. There's plenty of smash headlights this weekend. If you're thinking of coming to one of these events, get a headlight guard. I'm just happy to follow. I don't know how long the race is going to be, but they give a last lap flag, so I'll follow and we'll see how we get on. Thank you. Oh, nice little tarmac up here now. This is always very slippery. Really tricky to find grip on aggressive novelties. He's going to do better with tires. That's a good line through there. That was well done. Take it nice and wide rather than cutting tight. Right. Now this is probably the most technical bit left in the track. And it is hard going. serious ruts opening up. This was so smooth on the first lap of the first race. Deep hole downhill, first gear really slow, try not to make a tit of ourselves. It's drying as well, it's kind of become like this clay, and because the ruts are drying up, they want to pull your front wheel and go left here.